together. God bless you. They were saying, you don't have permission to film me. And then I didn't want to provoke them, and I kind of turned the phone away. But then I thought, well, they might attack me, so I better keep filming. And so the lady came out of the car, and she kind of tried to grab the phone from the young man that was preaching first, and he ducked out of the way. And she came at me, and she just kind of clobbered my hands. I guess I must have been holding my phone with both of my hands, because one hand was bruised and the other hand was hurt. So it's kind of hard to remember exactly what happened, but my son said she kind of clobbered my hand. Then she ran off with my phone into her car. And then I ran after her, and I said, give me my phone back. Then the clinic worker started, and she threw my phone onto the grass. I went and picked it up, and then they sped off.
And what, just to explain, what were you doing outside of the clinic that day?
I was trying to plead with mothers, telling them, we have help for them. That's an abortion day there. Well, she was provoked. I didn't directly speak to her at all. So, I mean, I saw the clinic workers yapping in her ear and hugging her, and I don't know what they're up to. They're very evil. So, I don't know if she had an abortion. She seemed pretty feisty and strong for somebody that's had an abortion.
Well, do you think your actions provoked her?
I think her conscience provoked her. Or the clinic escorts provoked her. The week before, they incited an NFL player to threaten me. So I don't know what's going on with their tactics and stuff. They're trying to scare me off.
To me, it sounds, you keep bringing up the clinic workers.
Yes.
You said either her conscience or the clinic workers provoked her action?
Yes.
Why do you think that?
Because the women that go in there know that they're murdering a baby. So they know, they all know that. And so I don't know if she did it or not. I don't know why she was there.
Now, knowing that this clinic in Huntsville does perform abortions, and knowing research shows the emotional, psychological effects of women who do choose to have abortions, the emotional after effects, I guess I could say, for women who do make that decision. So knowing that women who leave there potentially are in a fragile, emotional state, they're leaving there, you know, maybe, I mean, certainly, you know, different than how they walked in. Knowing that women leaving that clinic are potentially very emotionally drained, to say the least, and not knowing how that woman was feeling or doing, do you think that you're a sympathetic character? Are you really a victim when women are potentially leaving that place feeling very low and very empty? Are you still the victim for pleading with people who have just potentially gone through something life-changing?
Yeah, I'm not trying to be the victim here. I'm there to save innocent babies that are being tortured to death, literally, torn apart, alive. So, I mean, up to 21 and a half weeks. And, you know, if they feel a little shame for going in to murder their babies, I believe they should feel some shame, because it's a heinous thing. God said, thou shalt not kill. There's nothing worse than shedding innocent blood. And when they come out, and I know they've had if I can tell they've had an abortion, because they're usually weak, sometimes they're collapsing, I'll say, hey, we can help you. You know, there is forgiveness, and I try to be very gentle with people. But this is a last-ditch effort to save a baby from a horrible death. So
you said you're not trying to be the victim here, is what you
no.
said. So you were...
I was victimized, but it's nothing compared to what the babies are going through.
So, I guess, do you think that this woman assaulting you, this woman lunging at you, is this a reason for people to feel sorry for you or to feel bad that you endured something like that?
I mean, I don't care if people feel sorry for me. I care about those babies that are being tortured. So, you know, I do want the pro-abortion, pro-death side to be shown for who they are. They have no respect for life. And other people that are doing what I'm doing all over the country are being violently attacked. Two old people were just attacked in the last 2 months. One lady's leg was broken. So I want, you know, the pro-abortion side is very violent, and I would like people to see that.
And so for you, knowing that you've seen it happen to other people, you said,
yes.
And you have now been, someone has physically touched you over what you were doing outside of the clinic.
Yes.
Is it still worth it for you now, having gone through something like this?
Yes. I mean, I went halfway around the world to go to a war to protect this country, and I'm not letting this happen on my watch. I'm not going to go halfway across the world to defend Kuwait and let 3,000 babies be murdered every day. It's not happening. I won't. Lord willing, I will never give up. So.